everybody. So, as you
saw. Why do you talk like that?
Hello, everybody.
Why do you talk?
Shut up!
Why don't you just talk in your normal voice?
Hello, everybody.
Not the fake vlogger voice that you use.
What's my normal voice then?
What are you talking now?
Hi, everybody.
Oh, hey.
So, you guys saw the video. I hope you're crying, because I did. When we were editing it, like, I saw the video more than, like, I think 12, 15 times and counting. So, what are you doing?
What?
You can't play with that.
What?
Because it gets...
Okay.
So most of you have been asking us how he did it, how he got the ring. So many were asking what ring this is, like how many carat, the clarity.
Do I need to answer that?
No, you don't need to answer it, because let's keep some things private. This was a proposal that basically even I wasn't gonna go for. So let me give you a rundown. On 13th Jan, I got invited for a tasting from Jumeirah Group, the outlet manager of Somersault, and then I completely ignored it. I had like the worst week, so I was just like,
actually you didn't ignore it. You saw it and then didn't respond.
Yeah, so I ignored it. So he came over the next day and then he saw it and then he was just like, shit, she saw it and she didn't even like reply. It had cocktails, shisha, good food, it was on the beach
side. Actually I was offended because I formed like this invitation, like wording that I thought that she would be excited about. I said beach, sunset, cocktails, shisha. And I thought that, okay, she's gonna be like, oh my gosh, Jake, let's go for this. But clearly she didn't give a shit.
Yeah, because I was really busy. So Jaidel was the event organizer and Mimo is one of his besties. And then Jake and I got along with Mimo and Jaidel really well, like 3 years ago.
Amazing people.
They're both amazing people. And
huge shout out to them, because I don't think this would have happened if it
wasn't wouldn't have happened without Mimo, okay? So basically, Jake knows, and even Jaidel, and probably even Mimo, know that if they invite me, I can't say no. Like, I can't say no. So Mimo was like, please come, please come, please come. So we never say, like barely ever say no to them. So then I was just like, okay, Jake, that's when I asked Jake on Wednesday that, hey, should we go for this? And then he's like, babe, it's up to you.
Yeah, I'd play it cool, right?
And then basically we decided to go. On Thursday, I had such a cramped up week. I went to Abu Dhabi every single day. I wanted to do my nails, okay? Because I had like 2 chipped nails. So I told Jake that I really wanted to do my nails. And so my followers asked me, did you know, because your nails were perfect.
She always just has her nails that way all the time. Even if...
Yeah, so it's... because I have shoots usually, I like... prefer having my nails perfect. So anyway, so then that's what happened and then I got there. So now Jake, it's your turn. Like, explain, how did you plan the memory?
Okay, I'll try to explain it best as I can. In terms of timelines, I think it took about, I would say, 2 months of planning, because obviously I had to put in a lot of research into the ring first, right? Because obviously that's a huge investment and I wanted to make sure that that it was that it was something that she would really like. So obviously there were other people involved, you know, just to get their opinion, to make sure that, you know, it's something that Naomi would like as well. So I think that started in November, then going to different places, because you really want to make sure that because you really want to make sure that you do this right, because it's a lot of money. Yeah. So I made sure I checked out a lot of places, and then when I finally went to the place where I think had very wide range of options, because I was surprised that a lot of the places I went to had very, very limited options, honestly, which was quite weird. So it was just a couple of places actually that really had options where you could, you know, decide the size, work on the cut, work on like so many things. Yeah. So once we finally found a good place, then that was when I like got her mom involved, like Jade as well, obviously, and just ask them if they thought that this would be something that she likes. Obviously, your mom actually helped a lot with everything. And yeah, I don't think I would have been able to choose such a great thing if it wasn't for your mom. But yeah, so that was the first part of it. I think that was quite stressful as well, because you want to look for the right ring, you want to make sure that you know, you find something that's good but as well as what matches your budget. So that's quite stressful as well. But I think the more stressful part is when then we actually have to think about doing it, right? So I thought that getting the ring would be the hard part, but then no, it was actually really hard to think about what I wanted to do and how I wanted to do it and all that stuff.
How did you decide that? So I actually never asked you that.
So first I needed to think about what exactly I wanted to do and when I wanted to do it. So the when part, I got to pretty quickly. I wanted it to be in the beginning of the new decade, 2020. So that was, it wasn't too hard. But then to think about how I wanted to do it and like where and all those things, that was, I think that was the hard part. But I think I had a general idea that I wanted it to be next to the beach at least, really intimate, because as much as Naomi is like an influencer, she actually doesn't like hanging around people a lot. So I wanted to make sure that it was just the two of us and like in a more intimate setting. And yeah, and that's where Jardel came in, and you know, his company, Event Chic, the whole team is so amazing. They really, really helped out with.
So like, it was like an empty beach, by the way. That entire setup you saw in the videos.
Well, actually, it wasn't.
It was just sand. Because yeah, yeah. After they removed it, that's when I was like, oh so, my god, there was like there was that much effort involved in that setting.
Yeah, because all I did was I came out with my ideas to like Jardel and his team. And I told them that, look, I wanted to do it. Of course, they had their own ideas as well. Like, they were thinking about doing it somewhere, like, you know, getting a Burj Khalifa and all backdrop and all this. But I wanted it to be like, more.
I think Burj Khalifa, by the way, to the guys who want to propose, I think Burj Khalifa, all the places you can see Burj Khalifa from, they're more city. But the places you can see Burj Al Arab from, they're more on the beach.
So that's what we were talking about. Like Burj Khalifa for sure, like in terms of backdrop, it would have looked amazing.
Yeah.
But then like in terms of the actual atmosphere and the ambience that you want to create, it might be different because it's more like, you know, concrete jungle stuff. So that's what I told them as well. Like I wanted it to be more intimate, more like outdoorsy, and like definitely probably get the beach involved. So that's when they told me about this place, Somersault, and I was like, which
1 minute. Jake, continue.
Okay.
Continue.
Okay, this feels so awkward. You're gonna cut this stuff out, right?
Yeah, of course.
So that's when they told me about this spot and it looked amazing. I just saw a couple of pictures. I went to check it out. And then when I went there, it looked like really, really nice and beautiful. And that's when I knew that, okay, I think Naomi would really, really love this. Like, I went around sundown as well, so it was like very nice. Like, obviously, I had some ideas of like how I wanted it to be, like where I could take her through like a small kind of journey that we've had so far. But then obviously these guys really, really took it to the next level. Got this whole idea of actually making a lane of pictures. I wanted to have like our journey somehow where like pictures probably hanging or something like that. This idea. So they really, really helped with like everything, and they made the process super simple. I think that's okay. Yeah, and I think then once we actually got down to what we wanted to do, how we wanted to do it, and like when, that's when we thought about, okay, how do we get Naomi there? That was when like we said, okay, look, it's since she's an influencer, it's easier because then an event seems like it doesn't seem weird to her. But it was just about like formulating it the right way. I was like, I'll make sure the invite is like, you know, has the correct wording. She'd really be interested. But like, wow, that was clearly a fail.
We were just so we wanted to go to the beach anyway, but we were gonna go to kite beach.
That's why I thought that it would be easier when we send. But I didn't even know that we were gonna go to the beach that weekend. But still, I thought it would be so much easier when she told me, let's go. She's like, okay, cool, awesome. This is, once she gets an invite, she was like, oh shit, dude, let's just go here. But she didn't give a shit. And I was freaking out so much because I was like, dude, like, what is going on? And I was talking to Zeba as well. And Zeba was like, imagine if she tells one of us to go there.
No, that, dude, I was actually considering sending it to my tasting crew, like for them to.
I thought you would at least ask me. Right now I feel like you probably get invited to such cool shit, you don't even bother asking me and you just don't give a shit.
I'll ensure I ask you for everything. So then after your calendar gets booked out, don't blame me.
But this was actually something cool. Anyway, yeah, then that's when we had to get, what are you doing? that's when I had to get other people involved. So then that's when Mimo got involved.
Can you believe it? Mimo got involved.
We had to make it seem like, okay, this is something that he and Jardel like worked on, and he. So that's when he called and be like, oh, please come. We really, really want you there. You can meet all of us. It's been so long. Yeah. That's when she finally sent it to me as well. And then I could go like, oh yeah, like it's been a while, I don't mind going, and I'm still very cool, but like, I could at least try influencing her more then. And then
that's it. So then that's what happened.
Yeah.
Were you nervous?
Yeah, obviously, I was very nervous.
Have you ever been very nervous?
Not for such a long time. I felt like it was so like, because through the course of like all these, the 2 months, it was just like, you're like, okay, the ring, okay now, like, how do I do it? And then like, so it was that was always at like the back of my mind, and as obviously with work as well, it gets stressful at times, but like, yeah, I think once it got done, I think I can sleep peacefully now.
So guys, anyway, so that's how he did it. If you have any more questions except about my ring, let me know in the comments below. Obviously, like, share, subscribe, comment, whatever. So, Jake, say it. Like, share, subscribe, comment.
I feel like such a weird YouTuber now.
Like,
share, and subscribe, guys. Subscribe button. Click. Right below.
So,